This rule checks for areas of high crosstalk coupling. Crosstalk is unwanted interference of an aggressor net on a victim net. When the aggressor net switches its voltage values, a victim net might see some change in voltage as well. This effect is unwanted and should be avoided. A net might become a victim net if it's routed too close to a fast switching net or an aggressor net, or if they share a return path. To run this rule, layer information should be set up properly in project data. We can add IBIS models, which are optional, to get more accurate results. It also requires a user object list that lists all the high radiation nets. Those nets are considered as aggressors since they are constantly switching. If no object list is provided, Hyperlinks DRC will treat each and every net as an aggressor. In the parameters, we can define the coupling threshold over which the nets will be considered to be affected by crosstalk. I am going to run this rule on DDR nets on both single-ended and differential nets. I have already created the object lists and rule groups for the same. Clicking on violation will highlight the net and show which aggressor is responsible and how much is the crosstalk value. Nets highlighted in red are the aggressors. In order to fix the violations, we can add guard bands, increase the separation between two signal traces, or route them on different layers altogether. This way, Hyperlinks DRC helps find nets which might be adversely affected by crosstalk without having to set up any signal integrity simulations.